First of all, we'll write common name. The class Echinoidea is commonly called sea urchins. The class Echinoidea are commonly said as sea urchins. Then some more are there, like heart urchins. Some are called heart urchins, and some are called sand dollars. Sea urchin, heart urchin, sand dollars, and some are called sea biscuits. Sea biscuits are there, and cake urchin, sea biscuits, cake urchins. Generally called sea urchins. There are some other names like heart urchin, sand dollar, sea biscuits, cake urchins, likewise. Okay, so now that let's come with the characteristic features here. Body is ovoid. Body is ovoid or discoid. Body is ovoid or discoid. Okay, just we made it out. Body is ovoid or discoid. That is the first point to be remembered. Okay, that is the first point. Body is ovoid or discoid. Ovoid in sand dollars and discoid in ovoid in sea urchin, discoid in sand dollars. Okay, so that we'll write ovoid and or discoid. Sand dollar, that in case of sea urchin, ovoid. In case of that sand dollars, that is discoid. Sea urchin, sand dollars, disc like. Okay, next, covered with movable spines, that we'll write. Movable spines, that is our second point. Covered with movable. So it's our privilege to say, that means how you draw diagram is no matter, because we are not going to draw this diagram in examination. Next, Echinodermata is special for arms, but that arms are absent. Arms are absent. In these organisms, arms are absent. Next, 2 feet. In the ambulacral water vascular system, the 2 feet are having suckers. So that we have to write as a fourth point. The 2 feet bear suckers. 2 feet bear suckers. So calcareous acicles of the body unite to form a rigid test or corona or case. In one place I'll show you that all that particular calcareous acicles of the body that are going to become. So let me show you the acicles first. So these are the calcareous acicles. All the calcareous acicles are going to fuse and form test or corona or case. That is our fifth point. So writing it as fifth point. Calcareous acicles are of the body unite to form a rigid test or corona or case. So madreporite and anus. Madreporite and anus are going to be aboral in position. That is the sixth point. Madreporite and anus are aboral in position. Next, ambulacral grooves. Ambulacral grooves, I'll draw one more. Ambulacral grooves are closed. Ambulacral grooves are closed. That is the seventh point. Ambulacral grooves are closed. Next, pedicillariae, making adjustment the place. Pedicillariae is three-jawed. Three-jawed pedicillarium is the eighth point. Pedicillariae are three-jawed. Okay, no need to say linear order is not at all required. Just pedicillariae are three-jawed. In the mouth of sea urchin, a complex 5-jawed masticatory structure is present. That I am writing that specially. That is very, very, very important thing. A complex 5-jawed the masticatory structure is present. What do you call it as? Aristotle lantern. Okay, that is the next point, ninth point. Aristotle lantern. That is very, very important. When the classic Echinoidea is asked in 4 marks question, they will look for this particular character. Okay. Next, the development include indirect development. It include a larval form. We say Echinopluteus. Echinopluteus is the larva. Okay. So along with that, we should go with examples. Okay. Examples I am writing here. Echinus. Echinus is commonly called sea urchin. Okay. Echinus is commonly called sea urchin. We have one example. Next. Echinocardium. It's there in the name to say common name. Echinocardium. What is echinocardium? Heart urchin.
Heart urchin.
Very good. Echinocardium. Heart urchin. Okay. Next. Echinodiscus. I'm writing here. Echinodiscus. Making space for adjustment. Echinodiscus. Echinodiscus is commonly called sand dollar. Echinodiscus, commonly called sand dollar. Next, Clypeaster. Clypeaster is commonly called cake urchin. If not possible to write all the examples, you write at least two. So that's why we made it two here, two there. So you just remember any of the two. Okay. So let me say once again, the Echinoidea, class Echinoidea, commonly called sea urchins or heart urchins or sand dollars or sea biscuits. Or cake urchins. Okay. Next, number one, body is ovoid or discoid. Ovoid in sea urchin, discoid in sand dollar. Next, number two, the body is covered by movable spines. Body is covered by movable spines. Number two. Next, number three, what is this? Arms are absent. Arms are absent. Number four, tube feet bear suckers. Number five, where is it? Should go in order. Tube feet bear suckers. Next, number five, calcareous acicles. Here it is. We are not able to see. Calcareous acicles. Of the body unite to form a rigid test or corona or case. Okay, next. Then madreporite, number six, madreporite and anus are aboral in position. Madreporite and anus are aboral in position. Next, ambulacral grooves are closed. Number seven, ambulacral grooves are closed. Next, number eight. Pedicellarium or three jawed. Okay, next. The five jawed ringed structure, number nine. Five jawed ringed structure in the mouth of sea urchin, a complex five jawed ringed masticatory apparatus, what do you call Aristotle lanthan, is present. Development include Echinopluteus larva. Okay, so now. I am removing everything here. Okay. Now, let's try to practice. It is a little difficult compared with the previous one. Let's try to practice here. The class Echinoidea. Number one.
It belongs.
Yeah, we should say body shape. Ovoid or
class
ovoid and
number one, ovoid or discoid. Yeah, very good. Next, number two. Here it is. Framing body, of the sentence.
Yes, the body bears.
No. Framing of the sentence we'll do later. Wait. Sentence framing we'll do later. By looking toward this, what it comes in mind that you say that's all. Number two.
Spine.
Movable spines. That's fine. Number three.
Arms does not contain arms.
Yeah. Framing afterwards we'll look forward. Arms are absent. Okay. Number four.
Suckers.
Few feet bear. Suckers. Okay. Number five. Test or corona or case. That's all. Number six. Madreporite anus. Aboral in position.
Anus aboral in position.
Aboral in position. Number seven. Number seven. Ambulacral grooves.
Ambulacral grooves closed.
Okay. So I'll do one thing. We'll put the AG here. That will understand clearly. Ambulacral grooves are closed. Okay. Next, number eight. Pedicillarium.
Three jawed.
Pedicillarium, three jawed. Nine.
Aristotle.
Length. Okay, five jawed. Yeah, very good. Five jawed masticatory structure. Aristotle length. Okay. Let me say once again. It is little difficult, I accept, but by practicing will come easily. Body is ovoid or discoid. Number one, body is ovoid or discoid. Even numbers not required. Just go through the order, whatever you made it out. If you are able to draw this simple diagram, not in examination, in your own, if you are able to draw, that will be enough for us. Ovoid or discoid, pedicillarium, three jawed, arms are absent. Then here it is, anus and madreporite, aboral in position. Next, ambulacral grooves are closed, two feet bare suckers, Aristotle lanthan. Then test or corona or case. Likewise, just simple words. Framing we'll do later, like this, that body is ovoid or discoid. Ovoid in sea urchin, discoid in sand dollars. The pedicillarium is a three-jawed structure. Likewise, pedicillarium, three-jawed structure. Arms are absent. Then anus and madreporite is aboral in position. Ambulacral grooves are closed. Two feet bare suckers. The five-jawed ringed masticatory structure called Aristotle lanthan. The calcareous acicles of the body used to form the test or coronar case. That development is indirect with a larval form called Echinoplutius. You take the screenshot, you practice it 5 to 6 times and try to draw the diagram without seeing that. If you're able, you can write that particular points comfortably and take the screenshot of this. Wait.
So, that means,
sir.
Second year.